Hello friends, welcome to Tutorialspoint. In this tutorial, we will discuss about how we can use the tables in SAP HANA database. So, SAP HANA, it is an in-memory database wherein we can use almost all the features which are available into our conventional database. So, we can perform the DDL, we can perform the DML, we can perform the DCL, and we can all access these things like tables, views, functions, triggers, and we can access it from the catalog tab. So, we can do this with the two methods, either by using the SQL editor or by using the GUI option. So let's see how we can use the SQL editor and the GUI option to create the tables in the SAP HANA database. So we will go to the desktop wherein we have the SAP HANA Studio. So this is my HANA system and I'm connected to the HANA system using the user HANA user. So if we go and expand to the catalog tab, in this we have the various schemas. So let's say if we go to our schema, which is the training one, and in under this schema, we can see the different objects like the column views, models, functions, indexes, procedures, tables. So we have almost all the functionalities which are there in the conventional databases into the SAP HANA DB as well. So if I expand the tables here, so I can see that here are the n number of tables. And now, if I want to open up the SQL editor to create the new table, so I can select either the schema or the table, and now this option of opening the SQL console will be highlighted. So once I will click on it, it will open up the SQL console, and herein I can write down my SQL query. So I have just copied the query to create a column table sample 1. I will just copy it. And I will put it in the SQL editor. Now I will go to the execute and run it. So here I can see that the statement is successfully executed in this much of time. If I refresh here from the tables, I will be able to see my table which I have just created, which is the sample 1. Now let's say if I have to insert the data into this table, so I can copy the insert statements. I can go back to the studio and I can run the insert statements into my SQL editor. So I will just select it and I execute it. So I can see that the statement is successfully executed. And if I go here, select my table, right click and open up the data preview. So I can see that these three rows which I have just inserted using the insert statement, they are available into my table. So this is where we can create the table and we can insert the data. We can create the other objects like synonyms, procedures, functions, views using the SQL editor. Now let's see how we can do that using the GUI. So I will just select the tables. I will click on write and here is the option of new table. If we click on new table, I can simply give the table name here. Let's say if I give sample 2. Here I have to select the schema. So by default, it will select the schema which is selected. And if you want to change it, you can just go to the drop down and you can change the schema from here. After that, you have the type of the table. So you can either select the row store, column store and the table type based upon your requirement. Then you have to give the table name. Let's say, not the table name, the column name. So let's say if I give the name as ID, I will select the data type from here. Let's say if I give it as integer, I can make it as a key by clicking here. After that, let's say I want to add another column. I will click on this plus sign. I will give name. And let's say if I want to give the data type as varchar, I can specify the length here. And if I want, I can also make it a key, but I don't want to make it a key, so I can leave it blank. Similarly, if we want to make any comments for the particular column, if we want to give any default value to the column, so we can do that from here. So once it is done, you will simply click on the execute. And now you can see that the statement is executed successfully. Now if you go here to the tables, if you right click and refresh, you will be able to see the second table which we have just created using the GUI option in SAP HANA Studio under the catalogs. So if I go here and double click on it, so it is the same structure which we have just created, the ID, name and the other things. So in this tutorial we have seen how we can create the tables and the other databases objects in the similar way in HANA DB using the SQL editor and using the GUI option. Thank you.